Doghouse by Archie550. I don't know how many maps are in this, but I'm asked to play 1, 2, and 4. This is a Plutonia Wad. Oh, in the doghouse, properly, I suppose. It's Plutonia Wad. I guess top dog is Ultraviolence. This is a Lunar Cargo Bay, 43, 2, and 3. Very lunar indeed. A lot of grays, whites, and blacks. Come on, GZ Doom. You know what? I thought this seemed a little bit familiar. I've played this before. Yeah, I remember these G's. I've played this before. I don't know how much of it I've played. I know I played. I think I played a couple maps though. Yeah, I don't, it was a while, it was several weeks ago, probably, at least. Huh, shootable switch. What the heck? That's some sort of joke. I don't really remember this, that just says, there's nothing in here. One out of three. It's really not so bad. I mean, it's a lot of kind of the same colors, but there's kind of just enough variety in the textures. We get this Rock 5 modification here. And a couple of different flats. Maybe could use one more texture with some color to it to kind of spice it up a little bit more. Like maybe just some Ashwall, either Ashwall Original or Ashwall 2, I believe is the black, grayish black one. Just one more shade might be interesting. Plutonia Wad. Gotta remember that when I load it up every time. Yeah, I do kinda remember this part. Oops. That's a secret. Oh, that's a normal secret. Looks like I can go up here. Doesn't seem to do me any good though. Ah. Oh man. Oh, I gotta. Okay. Gotta get some momentum here. I guess nothing in there. Not really a point to do that. Okay. The texture usage is, I like the different bricks here. That's kind of a nice little touch. Kind of weird use of this light texture. This is normally a flat. And it's being used in some kind of odd ways, but at least it does provide some lighting here. Kind of basic skylight. This is kind of a rough transition here. I'd like to see a small brown trim, brown square trim around that, maybe. Because this is Z Doom we're in. This is, I don't know, UDMF format. I mean, there's a lot you can do. Might as well do some of it. That's a simple thing you can do. You can do that on vanilla. See, that's kind of weird because the trap is behind me, so... Oh, wait. Do I have to go back here? Oh, I guess I do. That's kind of a weird progression. Kind of cool scenery out here. Yeah, again, you can kind of see how this would benefit from one more, maybe darker shade of something. So yeah, like I said, I think an ash wall would work well. Okay, it's kind of a weird progression, because I don't remember seeing anything that would open. I mean, I'm still going to be surprised. I vaguely remember the map, but I don't remember it enough to, like, predict what happens or what switches and things do. Wait. This wasn't here before, was it? Maybe not. Maybe that's what happened. I dodged that fireball twice before finally landing on it. And there's my exit, huh? Yeah, very simple for an opener here. There's one more secret somewhere, but... meh. Okay. Yeah, so decent touches of detail. It's a little bit vanilla-ish looking, I guess. Feels a little bit bare yet. And there's kind of a lot of pretty wide open space, so it's kind of an empty map, but, you know, it's a map one. It's I guess... yeah, the G's was weird. Were weird, and the one secret was really weird. But what I like about this so far is that its presentation is polished enough that you feel like the mapper knows what they're doing. Like for example, it has, you know, these different graphics already. It's got an opening screen. It's got an M Doom. It's got the dog cursor and the different skill levels renamed. And the custom music, even in the intermission screen. So you feel like this is, it's presented in a polished way. So I'm sure that what comes next will pick up the difficulty and everything. But yeah, I mean, not a bad opener. That's Lunar Cargo Bay, map one of In the Doghouse.